episode of the podcast, ladies and gentlemen. This is number 48.
And before we get started, you guys hit that subscribe button and turn on your post notifications so you can keep up with every time we drop an episode.
Uh-huh. As you can see, we are not at 9029 Liberty right. Road, Randallstown, Maryland, the home of TNT Auto Detailing. We'll be at the studio next week.
Yeah, you know I'm so excited about that. Y'all look forward to all the new stuff we're going to have behind us.
Yeah, dig. Yeah. But the show must go on because today we got a very special guest in the building with us. Another major reason to society.
Reason.
Yeah, yeah. What's going on, man? It's your boy Remy Rugen here. TMG shit. You know, back for a second time. First time came my brother. You know, right. Shout out to the big steppers. Now we bigger. You know, right. So NBK Truck. My bro Twan, my bro Troy, boy, man, we up in this bitch. Dare to imagine. Let's get it.
Like, let's get it.
Shout out Reason to Society for having me, man, for a second time.
My man.
Yeah.
I am the real Red Nose.
And I am Tierra, but you guys know you can call me T.
And this is Reason.
Yeah.
Reason. Reason to Society. Reason.
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 Woo! Y'all energy unmatched, man. I'm trying to tell you, y'all energy is fire.
The official Remy Ruger. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
when we connected, you told me you blessed the show for the second time. Yeah. We was incredibly honored. You feel me?
I had to.
My man, I'm personally honored, you dig? Because I feel like you and your team about to blow.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm
saying?
Yeah,
I appreciate that, yeah.
Yeah, man, you definitely a man of your word. You came through, double back with us. You know what I'm saying? Last time you came through, views was out. It was going crazy on all major platforms.
It went stupid.
You know what I'm saying? You, MBK Truck, Big Steppers, what y'all got in store for us, man? What's in the stash?
Right now, I'm going to be open on this. You know, this is more of a personal one right here,
okay.
So we're going to get deep.
Let's go.
The album is under renovations as well. Like, we just wanted to Truck wanted to take some more time and remix. You know, we do everything ourselves.
Word.
He wanted to remix and get it tightened up and make sure we put it out. People been waiting for this project for a couple years.
Yeah, man.
So he wanted to make sure it was perfect. So that's under renovations. Big Steppers is next, man. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, like, everybody ever used the term, you know, but it's just like nobody really own up to it and show how, like, we stepped into this music game, two big feet, you feel me? And comparing it, we the real ones.
Word up.
That's
word
how
up.
That's how we see it. And now we, look, in that little bit of time, man, like I said, my boy Twan, Troy boy, everybody taking initiative to learn something and be a part of it. How you stepping?
Building a team.
Build the team in a way is big, man.
Huh,
we take big steps now. Yeah, don't do not small.
Major moves coming soon, you know what I'm saying? Talk about some relocations in the works.
Yes,
you know
sir.
Anything right. You can tell us, let us know about that.
Man, I'm going to all of Georgia Peach, man.
Georgia Peach, man.
Yeah, I'm going to the A.
Word
up. You know, keep it G, you know, me, my family, you know, my wife, my children.
Okay.
And I ain't talking too much, but we going there and y'all gonna see what happened next, but it's gonna be huge.
Exactly.
You know, let us know where should we go.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, drop that below. You
drop
know
that
saying?
Shit below.
You dig? As long as I know you, man, like TM, Timeless Music,
yes, sir.
Has always been attached to your name.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Is it a label? Are you the founder of it? Like, what's the inside scoop, man?
Right.
All right, so Timeless Music was originally just Timeless Music. Mm-hmm. And you know, as a kid in a dream, you would try to make sense with that. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I don't know where I was at them years when I made Timeless Music.
Like,
but
what, age? What age are we talking about?
I think I was about 16.
Okay.
When that became official for me. 16.
So you was rapping before then?
Oh, yeah. I was a part of all types of groups. New Breed. I was with So Swag, too. Don't
word
get it fucked
up.
Yeah, I was one of So Swag Cat and his bro. Like,
okay.
Shout out my brother Tate now. You
shout
see
out.
Me yet? You know, so Timeless Music now is officially mine. Been officially mine, you know. Shout out to G Cash, you know, he was a co-founder.
Shout out.
And like, not even just a co-founder, like that man, him thought of that shit together. But I was like, bro, I gotta take this initiative to do this all the way.
Word up, word up.
Now we in a, I'm in a process of rebuilding TM as a label as it was supposed to be.
My man.
It's like you see Remy Ruger, you see TM. Or
straight up.
Legally, it's TMG, Timeless Music Group. Now.
Okay.
So, but that's the label.
TMG, baby.
Yeah. It's a beautiful thing, man. It's all about 90s. I'm a 93 baby. But, man, like, anybody who know me, you'll fuck around catch me playing Miley Cyrus. You'll fuck around catch me playing, like, Kiss.
Okay.
You'll fuck around and catch me playing more Raid. The next thing you know, I'm on the Ed Sheeran.
But you know what? It's funny that you say that, because that makes a lot of sense as to why your music is so versatile. Like, right. You're all over the place, and not everybody can do that. Man, I don't care what y'all think. Not everybody can do that.
Word up. And the lyrics still intact. Yes, you feel what I'm saying? You know how to really format a song. You know what I'm saying? Really, yeah, no matter what the genre is.
Exactly.
You have more fun making the music or performing the music?
Ooh.
That's a good one.
I don't know. I got a new way of making music now. So I think it's that. Only because, like, back then, I was doing a lot of writing. Like, I did a lot of writing.
I could tell, though, yeah.
And that shit was, like, I ain't gonna lie, sometimes a headache.
Yeah.
Shout out my bro, Dead Imagine, actually on the camera as well.
Word up. Shout out.
Dead Imagine. But that's my full-length proof to how I do. And there's a lot of people that don't be there. I don't work around a lot of folk, which I can, but I don't. I like to focus. And he sat there with me plenty nights, bro, and I'm just going off. And he'd be like, what the fuck, bro? No pen. Like, like Selfish. That was not written. I just
word up.
Love that.
Just felt it.
Yeah. Yo, this whole next project I'm dropping is like, basically, I think I wrote maybe one song.
Word up. Damn.
But it feels so good, bro. Okay. So I think now is making it, performing it. I like performing it. It's just where the crowd got to be into music.
Yeah.
I don't see why people come to clubs or, you know, you're coming to a...
Yeah,
if you're coming to a club to hear live artists, give me your energy.
Yeah,
give me
your
booze.
Right.
Some sort of energy.
Yeah,
yo, it's a new look in the crowd I've never seen. It's called the I Can't Do That. You know what that is?
No.
Okay. It's when an artist looking at you that went on before you and looking at you like, what
the
fuck?
Okay.
Nah, man, I ain't even showing his love. I can't do that.
Yeah,
I seen that look before, bro. Like, I don't care if he was out there whack. When you come to your good job, y'all take nuts to get up here.
Come on, bro.
It does.
Nah, I get down, man. Then people be looking at me like, nigga.
Crazy. And you know what you bring to the table. You feel me? Yeah. Ain't like you delusional like that. Yeah. Do I got it? Do I not? You got the sound. You got the lyrics. You got the whole package. You dig what
I just got that way, too. I was not confident.
Word up. Man, see? A lot of things that people wouldn't know from the outside looking at.
Too many people let me know, and then I start making this music, like, without the pen. I say, okay, all that practice makes sense. Okay.
Yeah, my man, you got any shows lined up, like, coming in the near future?
Hell yeah. All in Atlanta.
That's what's up.
Check them out down at A, you dig? Yeah. Make sure you follow them on Instagram, the official Remy Ruger.
Shout out my boy Spence, too, man. And shout out my boy 45 Op. Them niggas, you know, they already down there. And it's like, I got a foundation and family down there.
Yeah,
right. So it's kind of
important.
It's a family I grew up with.
That's
there already.
My man.
So when I get there, it's kind of like they set
going, nothing but love down there.
Nothing but
that,
it.
That gotta be a great family.
I love
it. What I'm saying? Especially when you change in states, locations, people, all that. You feel what I'm saying? It gotta be a good feeling. You know what I'm saying?
It is. It's beautiful.
Powered by J. Lee.
Yeah.
What y'all got going on over there, man? It looks like it's a lot of good things going on over there, man.
Well, you got Powered by J. Lee is really J. Lee.
Okay.
You know, me and J. Lee met a couple years ago. Well, not a couple years ago. I'm over-exaggerating like a bit. So I'm lying. I don't know why I just said because I'm in a zone with y'all.
Reasons.
But we met a year ago. And, I mean, if y'all want to hear that story.
Come on, bro.
Quickly,
bring it to us. So we here, bro.
You know,
baby,
Lee is a grinding-ass nigga, bro.
Word up. He looked like
a grinding-ass nigga.
Yeah.
And,
he do look at
I was fucked up. I was fucked up. And next thing you know, I'm actually... Sorry, Jay, but let's keep it G because people need to know where we came from.
Word up.
And, you know, at that time, not no more, but at that time, he was lifting. You feel me? Niggas had... ain't nothing embarrassing about that shit. Like, nigga, I did lift, nigga. Remy did lift 2020. I picked your bitch up.
And
dropped her off. I picked your gang up when y'all was drunk. That was me.
All that.
Right. Let's get that out there. But, like, he dropped me off. I went to go get some propane tanks for this new house I moved in. And there wasn't no heat yet. It ain't my fault.
Word up.
You know how Baltimore is. Welcome to the city state.
Yes, sir.
And, he the one who took me to go get the shit. And one day I just seen him. I was just like, bro, I don't know why, but you need to hear this. And he wasn't trying to hear that shit. And then he heard it. I heard from him about 2 months later, and we linked.
Word up.
And now, as you see with Powered by Jay Lee is, which mm-hmm. it was just Jay Lee and me. Yeah. Now you see what Powered Jay Lee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the whole umbrella.
Stretched out the whole, you know, the whole shit.
Word up. Mm-hmm.
And
that's really nice.
So it seems like you guys are like.
This is a gift from Truck, guys, by the way.
Nice. Yeah,
Truck got this custom made.
Make sure y'all follow him on Instagram. You dig what I'm saying? Definitely sharing the blessings on Instagram.
Yeah, that was crazy, bro. That was real, too. That wasn't like fucking acting, bro. Bro, I love you, bro. Appreciate you, man. New Jersey on the way.
Straight going on. I mean, City of Gods, man. So you want a new fresh attire?
Yeah,
right, I was checking that out. Yeah.
I mean, I think we sponsored by them still, so we working that out. I'm just keeping the G.
Sponsorship.
I don't lie. I'm not for no camera shit, bro. Like I'm still from where I'm from. Like don't get me fucked up. You see, I'm rocking the gear, nigga. Yeah. Y'all see what's going on? But at the end of the day, let's get some. I'm still trying to get the understanding out there, 100%. But my manager got it.
Word
whatever
up.
That is, I just heard a few things, but nigga, we here. Shout out City of God. Y'all can go holler at them. 1118 Holland Street, man. Just go grab your gear. They got some fresh shit for you.
Shout out. You know what I'm saying?
Let's work.
Out of My Mind Acoustics.
Mm.
Remy Ruger, Quentin Irvin. What inspired this collaboration, man?
Bro, that's a good fucking question. He is not shit for that good ass. I'm mad the nigga asked the best question in the world. And you know why it's the best, yo?
Let's go.
Quentin Irvin is a fucking legend. Like, the most humbled legend I've ever met in my life, bro. I'm talking about done played on some serious fucking albums. I'm talking about John Legend.
Okay.
I'm talking about he been everywhere. And he still go to church every Sunday.
Mm, humble.
And he live here every Sunday and every week of his life. And he still work. And he's just a legend at heart and don't brag about nothing. And the most... reason why that was so special question, bro. That's my uncle, bro.
Word.
That's my mother's brother. So I always look up to him like, bro, you used to take me in the, you know, the basement to fuck with the guitars. He got so many, right? Got some autographed by some greats, man. Mm-hmm. I'm just like, you know what? I want to have a long guitar.
Let's go.
I found that my fingers was too fat. I can't do that shit.
Oh, man.
So I don't know.
Come on. That's my excuse. Don't let them show you like that, my fat ass
went to the piano, bro. Like,
oh,
I learned piano instead, but like it was such a special moment. I'm talking about creating it.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously. Like, our studio was great.
Word up.
But I didn't know that we can make a production such.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, it was just like, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
He plugged it. He said, you know, you guys, I'm doing this like this, but I can plug in right through your... I'm like, well, plug it in. Oh, shit, let me see. And we did it live, him on the guitar, me doing that, and Dead Imagining Me was like trying to... He shot the video, by the way.
Shout out.
You did a great job on Emotions, bro. I appreciate you. I love you. And the way it came about was just so special because when we did it, the live, that's why I didn't say live. It wasn't live, but it was live how we made it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It was just amazing. And I'm famous for that.
So, Imagine shot that video. Amazing job, bro. Like, the whole thing was just great.
Amazing.
Like, the performance, you know what I mean? The film work, everything about
it. Amazing, bro. Yeah. I couldn't believe when he... And not only that was it amazing, I give so much props to... Shout out to Jay Lee as well. He made sure that location was secured for us.
My man.
The comfortability level was secured. Right. The incense, the candles was lit.
It
felt as good as it sounded. Mm-hmm. It felt as good.
That's
and it felt like we was doing it again. And Dad Imagine sent me versions of this shit.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't just say, here you go. He said, no, what you think about this one? What about that? Or maybe we can...
Yeah.
And he gave a fuck. And he always give a fuck, bro. Yeah. I love you, bro. Appreciate that.
Yeah, let's go, man. If it wasn't for rap, man, what would you be doing? What is it
that's
that Remy Ruger will be doing? What career choice, like, what alternative was there besides rap for you?
Shit.
If any.
If any. You know what I'm saying?
I had dreams, man, and aspirations. But I got sick when I was younger. It enabled me from doing school.
Mm-hmm.
So I dropped out in 12th.
Okay, damn.
Because I couldn't go to school.
Word
this
up.
Virtual shit wasn't like this. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah.
So I couldn't go to school, actually, at all, physically.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, okay, well, what's next? Because I had a dream of owning a hotel.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I did valet for a lot of them years. A lot of people who know me and see this podcast so know I did valet for years.
Word
like
up.
I was that rapping nigga, me, Tay Wilson,
mm-hmm.
Ernest Peso. We had so many real niggas who know here right now who did that shit at
Word
the up. Same fucking hotel that's closed down now, Embassy. right down St. Paul Street.
Anything happened for a reason, right?
But that was my aspirations and dreams. But if I wasn't actually rapping into a profession and all this is going on, right, and shit, I know where I'd be.
Word up, man.
I ain't even going to say it because I don't want to jinx myself.
I'll let everybody know where they can find you on every social media platform, all major platforms.
You can find me everywhere, man. R-E-N-Y-R-U-G-E-R. Put it on anything. Literally, like, I'm not bragging about it, but my team works so hard.
Throw it on Google, man. Anything going to pop up.
Google going to take you to another world. Shout out the distribution company, because it's shit on there I never even heard of.
Uh-huh. Word
that
up.
I'm on, so I'm going to just assume. I know it's 201 sites and streaming platforms and apps and PlayStation and X, all that shit.
Yeah, all that. Remy Ruger, you dig?
Appreciate that.
You know what I'm saying? Everywhere. You are now rocking with Reasons. You dig? I feel like as a podcaster, artist, whatever field that you're in, right, you are in the public eye. Mm-hmm. And you're subject to public opinion. You feel what I'm saying? What is the top three misconceptions people develop about you before they get to know you?
People say, I mean...
there
before they
go.
Meet you, the first thing they think
you
mean.
Yeah. You think that's just a black people thing? Like, is it something about the structure
and somebody
of
told me
face?
Somebody told me I got Ice Cube eyebrows, and I look mean.
What? Ice Cube
you ain't
eyebrows?
Shit, you not shit. But that's a true story. They say I got Ice Cube. You know, Ice Cube always look like he bugging.
Yeah, he do look like he
I said, the person said that shit ain't shit.
Yeah,
but
man.
They say I'm mean.
Just
look kind of mean, though.
Just off your appearance.
Like, unapproachable a little bit.
Like, I guess my face, if you want to just use that, I look mean and shit. I smile a lot. They say I look mean.
You ain't shit, T. T ain't shit for that.
They say I'm mean. They didn't think I had a voice like that.
What you mean as far as vocally?
Vocally.
Okay.
Vocally. Like, on that note. And then the last one I think is just
so
that,
do you use auto-tune on your vocals?
Partial.
Okay.
Out of my mind was straight.
Mm-hmm.
Straight
okay.
Me. That was on me.
Okay.
It sound crazy
so
as fuck.
So you a little singer on the low. People ain't know.
You been singing for a long time? Like, you grew up singing? This is what you do?
I'm not even going to say a lie. I'm not a good singer, bro.
But you can...
You work hard at it? What is it?
What's the keys
to it? Because I love to sing too, bro.
You know
my
the keys?
Still don't sing like yours. I sing
all
day.
I'm about to tell you the real keys.
Let's go.
I used to sound like a fucking horse, man. Like, I would... I actually love music so much, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I just went to John B, Jaheim, Anthony Hamilton, Erykah Badu.
That's my guy, Anthony
I went
Hamilton.
To, I'm telling you, the real vocal vicinities you'll hear me going. Mm-hmm. All the people got, you hear all the people I said? Like, mm-hmm. They don't go crazy.
Word
they
up.
Go at a tone.
They
and I kept,
within their element.
Kept singing.
Mm-hmm.
Until I found my tone in it. In Word their
up.
Song.
Word
Once
up.
I found my tone in their song, I'm like, it's no way I can sound like them.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome to the music industry.
Right.
That's how
yeah.
we do. And
yeah.
you gonna imitate all fucking day,
mm-hmm.
but I ain't never sound, I don't sound like any. I don't know who I sound like, but I tell you, I don't sound like none of them.
Mo 3?
Did somebody said Mo 3 and Raw Wave.
How do you take that comparison, though?
You
and Mo 3. The whole package. Look at the entire package. The look. The style, like, would
style.
You take that as a compliment?
For
or
some reason, I don't
as?
Know why, your style definitely was like, every time I seen like, that shit hard.
Yo, it was different, and you're, and the way you switch up, yo, you have a, remember I told you a little earlier, like, you have a different type of breakdown, like,
yeah.
A lot of people format their bars a little different than you do, like, mm-hmm. You'll take that half a bar or one bar and just break down,
right.
Pause, and then start a whole nother,
right.
You dig what I'm saying?
There's no ceiling to
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, Mo 3 was crazy
Mo
with
3,
that. So
Mo 3
why,
was one of my favorites, bro,
mm-hmm.
Like, I was watching Mo 3, I don't know if y'all remember. Y'all remember that little tick? It wasn't even TikTok. It was Vine. Remember he did that Vine like, I'll go to jail for that pussy.
Yeah, he did that shit.
And he
I
was funny.
Was
he had them big ass plastic chains on. I don't know if they was real or not.
Mm-hmm.
But the big ass AK. I was like, who the fuck is this dude? And then he did the Sierra remix.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh my God, y'all really can sing, even though he was just joking.
Word up, word.
Y'all really got it. And after that, I was a fan of him since, probably like Texas was to him. You feel me? Like, them people looked up to him out there.
Uh-huh.
And I feel like I did too, because that nigga had vocals, and next thing you know, he with Boosie.
Word
and then
up.
His shit is so unfortunate, bro.
Yeah, man. You know
so
how that go.
That would be your first, your top.
That's the first two. Yeah, that's the two.
The first two. So what would be your third?
As far as what?
Misconception.
Oh, damn.
Of yourself.
I made that misconception long. I'm sorry.
No. Actually, like two or three questions in between time.
Yeah, oh, okay. So what I said, I mean.
They know you can take it there vocally. Right.
Vocally, my fault, y'all. Yeah.
No, okay, you're good. Yeah. You're good.
Had a long day.
Vocally, that's how it should be.
And the last one is. Actually, this is surprised to see how funny I am.
Okay. Because you're a comedian on
that, that goes right with that first misconception. Like, mm-hmm. Y'all think I mean, but the whole time you get around me, you have a fucking ball, bro.
Word it up. Word it up.
So I think that would naturally, I see to be the one.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. What about y'all?
I'm going to say my first one is my age. Nobody ever can guess how old I am. People.
Yeah, that's very true. Yeah, you don't look your age at all.
So I'm gonna say that like people always thought I was like 18 forever. People think I'm like 24. I'm 32. Nobody believes it when I tell them.
Word.
I would say number two, people think I was stuck up, unapproachable.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you're pretty. You look stuck up, or you look like you don't. You know.
That's funny. Yeah. People always prejudging. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. Like that's they be putting their own joints on
you.
Yeah.
On you, it's like what? You didn't come to try to say anything to me.
She's unapproachable.
Right. I talk to everybody. Yeah. Very friendly. Social butterfly.
Yeah.
Number three, people think I don't eat. I love food.
What?
I love food. I know.
Now, that's a fucked up one. What is they trying to imply?
Like, you know, when you're slim, people be like, oh, you must not eat a lot. Actually, I do. I probably out-eat you. But, you know, misconception.
Yeah, that's a big misconception in this household. You feel what I'm saying?
Lucky, nigga.
Yeah.
I got to work this shit off.
Yeah, man.
So yeah. I would say that's my top three.
Yeah, mine is, I mean, just like
Remy. Unapproachable, yeah.
The average Baltimore nigga, I guess.
You walk around with the broke down face. The demeanor, bro. The standoff. Right. Yeah. You dig what I'm saying? So, and then it's like a contradiction.
Yeah.
Because nice guy, you feel what I'm saying? Yeah. A lot of people think I'm a nice guy. Right. And for some reason, everybody want to take people kindness for weakness. Yeah. Oh, he the nice guy. I can say this, so I can do this.
Exactly.
You feel what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Then you
put them in their place.
What they thought in the first place. Right. You was mean. You feel what I'm saying? I tried to give you the nice guy. That ain't working. Right.
That's crazy.
Most definitely an antisocial. If I don't know you, I really ain't banging with you. I don't got you much to say. You feel what I'm saying? I'm going to sit back. I'm going to listen to what you got to say.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to watch what you doing. You dig
what I'm saying? They say the more quiet, the more dangerous.
Right,
yeah, man. The loudest one in the room, the weakest one in the room. You dig what I'm saying? Sure. But one of the nicest guys that I ever met, I ever ran into in my life is Tavon Myers of TNT Auto Detailing. So let's go ahead and get into the sponsors.
What's up, everybody? TNT Auto Detailing here with you today. And today you're watching another episode of Reasons to Society. Let me tell y'all something, y'all. I've been enjoying these episodes since they pretty much started. I've been with them since episode 17. I became the sponsor in episode 17. And from there, I saw the vision with these two people and I knew that they were going to take off and that things were going to be awesome. So I need you to like, subscribe. Subscribe is huge. And comment. We need more subscribers. We need you to tell people about us so we can get more subscribers so that we can grow. And I am TNTL Detailing, the sponsor of Reasons to Society. We're located at 9029 Liberty Road. That's TNT Auto Detailing. Appointments only. You can call me at 443-220-4532 to book your appointment today. It's hot outside. It's summertime. Let's get it. Let's get back to Reasons.
And with that said, I think we're going to go ahead and get you know what I'm saying? I look at you like a pretty transparent artist.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying? I think it's very important because nowadays you got to be real relatable to your fans.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You dig what I'm saying? So let's talk depression. You feel what I'm saying? Over 300 million people worldwide suffer from it. You dig what I'm saying? And I so happened to run across a post that you posted on Instagram. Mm. And it said, and I quote, I said, Mama, I never learned how to deal with depression. Why shut me down? Why put me in a box like this?
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? Like, can you further expound on that post?
I understand it.
Word.
I understand it way too fond of it. Like I said, I was sick as a kid, man. Like, I don't know what happened.
Mm-hmm.
One day I was actually at Truck's mom's house.
Mm-hmm.
And my life changed forever one day. Like,
word
I went to a cookout. I found out what it was, but it took years.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
It took years to find out what that was. I was 16. Like, right at the height of when I was it was like 14. And then I just sat by the grill.
Mm-hmm.
And I just breathed them things in so hard, bro. Like, I'm just saying the story. We deep here, right? We
ain't got no time. Come on, this. Bro. Right. Yeah,
we going deep. Like, I want people to see this one.
Yeah,
this is
important. Yeah, sure. That's so, what about the whole thing up, bro.
Real shit. And then, like, I breathed in fumes, and, like, I was grown, bro. I was drinking, smoking weed, but I'm sitting by the grill. I don't know, man. Next thing you know, on the bus ride home back up to the village, I hopped out. I ran to some Mexican's house. I know that sound not real.
Mm-hmm.
But I was riding right up, like, by John Hopkins, and then I hopped out right on, like, I don't know where the fuck we was on. I think at that time the bus was called the 20.
Mm-hmm.
29, 20. I think it was the 20. The road from there to there. And, bro, I just hopped out, ran to some Mexican's house, bro. And my sister was with me at the time. And I don't know. I went to the hospital. They like, well, say you're high and you're drunk and you're underage and you're
geeking.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Whole time,
yeah.
Nigga, it took me years, bro, to like get out of that. Mm-hmm. Like, my throat, I was one of them guys that's like levels to anxiety.
Yeah.
I was almost at the peak.
Yeah.
Like, I believe like that going outside was like a fish out of water.
Word up.
Imagine that, bro. You go outside and you can't breathe. Yeah. Literally, my mind was saying you couldn't. And I didn't.
Damn, bro.
I didn't.
So you locked yourself in the house?
No, I ain't relaxed, bro. It was like a mini jail. Like, because I didn't live with my mom.
Mm-hmm.
I was gone with my mom at a young age, bro. Mm-hmm. So it's like, it's not her fault.
Word
you
up,
know,
word
it's
up.
Just, it's just I'm grown. Mm-hmm. Like, we got into it, I left.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And I don't know, bro. Like, that whole story leads up to the depression.
The smell of the grill and the fumes of everything going up just basically irritated you, and since then it caused you to have breathing problems.
It ruined the brain cells.
Word up.
That was the actual fact.
So you was formally diagnosed.
Formally diagnosed.
Word up.
With a psychosis and pre-suicidal.
Word up, bro.
Yeah, and, I tried that. I did that. And I definitely encourage. That's why I can't wait to make it, bro.
And this is from how many definitely years from the time that this happened to the time that you got diagnosed? What was the time period in between?
Right, yeah.
It took about a year and a half for the diagnosis, but not to fix the problem.
Word up.
Because everybody was just giving me shit. I'm probably one of the first niggas in the city who had Xanax.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's for anxiety. Prescribed, but now it's illegal, but I was probably the first nigga who had that shit. And that shit, ooh,
yeah,
I remember that shit. I was like, what the fuck is this shit?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
And I had so many pills, bro, like, no disrespect to old people, bro. It was like Sunday, Monday, man. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And I'm like,
it's ridiculous.
One day, bro,
I just the other pill.
Yo, one day I scooped them up.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck it.
Nah, bro.
Real life. Sheesh. I just fucking laid back in the tub.
How old was you at this point?
I was 15 by the time I did
that. Damn, bro.
I was done with it. And then my sister came in there and just.
When you say you
they
was
wasn't
done,
even coming.
When you say you was done, explain that. Like, do you feel like you were fed up with the feelings of not being able to have your old life back? Was it taking all the medicine? Was it everything all together? Like, what really got you to the point where you wanted to just throw all those pills down your throat?
I mean, if you look at what I was doing prior, mm-hmm. I was robbing niggas.
Mm-hmm.
I was in a studio. And Truck was having a time of our life, nigga, with the money. We was, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Now I ain't seen Truck for about a year. I stayed in the house for a year that at that time was like my sister's people's house because she was gone from her mother too.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? She wasn't even my real sister, but she was like my real sister. But,
word up.
And I just stayed in the house. So I didn't get to see nobody, like really. And it was just like I stayed under the humidifier like every day, all day,
right.
Trying to figure it out.
Mm-hmm.
So I think when I said I'm done, it was just like, bro, like, fuck. Like, I already was a go-hard-ass nigga.
My man.
I'm already not a bluffing-ass nigga, bro.
Word
so why am I about to bluff with this shit? Like, let that shit go, bro. Like, fuck it.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't got no kid. I actually lost a kid, like, recently. Off that, you feel me? Like, in that time of day,
mm-hmm.
I just lost a kid at birth.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? So it was just like, fuck. And then that bit left. You feel me? So I'm like, man, fuck this whole thing.
Right,
I'm
right,
young,
right,
like, man,
right,
fuck
right.
All this shit, man. Now look, like, I'm appreciative, but I can't wait to make it and start.
Huh.
I got at least like 2-3 foundations of mine.
My man,
for real, I done been homeless. I slept
now
down.
We talking,
I slept
baby.
Down the harbor.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? Remember they used to make the chocolate?
Yeah.
I ended up being one of them niggas who sung in that.
Mm.
You know, making
oh,
the chocolate,
up.
But I stayed outside of it.
Yeah,
I slept outside.
What, outside the entire joint or
outside the gallery?
Okay.
Yeah, remember they had the clothing mall, clothing
spot.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. They had the little mall seafood.
I never begged for a dollar.
My man.
If y'all niggas remember me, you see me on that bench, you never asked me, you never heard me ask for a black and mild, a man, cigarette,
got
or nothing.
Yeah, like you
got
a story,
hell of a success story, don't he?
Yeah. Yes. Shit, I wouldn't have been here where I'm at right now, though, for one, for my wife, though.
My man.
I was young.
Shout out to the wife.
Real shit, because she seen me when I was younger, too, but I was in my mode. I'm performing everywhere, nigga. Yeah. Remy man. Everywhere, truck everywhere, because we had Echo Music.
Yeah.
That shit flooded the fucking city before any fucking group you can think about. We was a group.
Okay.
Fucking like, we was a group. Mm-hmm. And everybody kept saying us, bro. Kevin Lyles, everybody just was fucking on us, bro. And I seen her, and then I ended up running the tour on a bus. I wasn't sick yet. Mm-hmm. Got a number, and was sick. Mm-hmm. Now I'm not worrying about none of that shit. Right. You feel me? And then, like, she just gave me a chance for a date. Mm-hmm. After that date, bro, build. She built me up. That's some real nigga shit I'm spitting on.
Yes, sir.
Like, yo, she built the nigga up to be able to see it.
Yes, sir.
It's not you. Yeah. It's not you.
There you go.
I seen you.
Mm-hmm.
This nigga knew, but... Word. Nigga, I see you.
My man.
Right.
Real life shit.
Yeah, shout
we
out
getting
to the
real
queen.
Today.
Right. Shout out to you,
most
girl.
Definitely. Yeah,
we getting real today on Reasons to Society.
Up. Yeah, so I guess that kind of answers one of my questions is like, how important is a support system around you when you're dealing with these things? You dig what I'm saying? I think you pretty much answered it right there. When you got a queen.
No. That's a different question.
Word up. My bad. Let me backtrack.
because ain't you heard me not had none.
Right.
Now, people think they've been a support system for somebody that's in depression.
Mm-hmm.
You got to understand depression.
Right.
You got to be non-selfish. You got to be non-judgmental.
Mm-hmm.
You call me, bro. I'm going through it. Yo, this shit fucked up. Ah, damn, bro. I'm sorry you're going through that, yo.
No empathy. People have to have empathy.
Right.
Yeah.
You call me.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, I'm going through it. Man, what's up? You good? Like, what's really popping? Like, what's going on? He never asked you what you going through. He just said, I'm sorry to hear that.
Right.
You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
A nigga about to dig in and let's talk about it. What's really going on?
Word up.
And then you can have people that surround you that get sick and it's hard to deal with depression too.
Mm-hmm.
Because, excuse me, they going through something and you're going through something and they can't handle your dwelling.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can't dwell. You can't depend on the people that's hurting too.
Mm-hmm. Word up.
So now it's a balance.
Woo, that's getting deep.
Real shit. That's it's a true. Balance. If y'all want to hear this, then people can really understand and learn something from this point. Because
yes,
I came from the bottom of a mental state where the term lose your mind actually made sense. Because I actually did to where I'm still fighting it today.
Bro.
You feel me? Like, if a nigga want to support you, how big is a support system? It could be one fucking person.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
How you support me is what
word
the fuck matters.
Don't
sit
up.
There and keep talking about you support me and you don't understand what the fuck I need for your support.
Right. What
up,
I need
bro.
From you.
I know y'all had this friend before. I'm going through it. Hell yeah, girl.
Yo,
I'm going through
me
it too.
Mr. Me
Hell,
too.
Mr.
Bro.
Me Too. Make the
Mrs.
fuck
too.
Out of here, bro.
Talk
been
about
through
Mr.
that.
Mrs. Me Too.
Like,
that's I didn't call you to talk about you.
Real shit. I need you. I'm calling you because I need to hear.
Vulnerable.
Eva, I need to hear you. Tell me I'm going to be okay, nigga. Mm-hmm. Don't fucking just hit me talking about you.
Word
yeah,
up.
Some people just want to vent. They just want somebody to listen to them.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like,
most
even
definitely.
If you can't help me, let me get this shit out.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Like, that matters.
I feel like venting back and forth is okay. Just let me get mine out, and then you go.
Yeah.
But after I tell you one thing.
No, man,
and
no.
then you go
no,
in.
No.
Yeah.
No. no, when I'm venting, don't go on my damn day. Wait for your turn.
Wait
till tomorrow.
Wait
Call
till tomorrow.
Call me tomorrow, man. You know what I'm saying?
I thank y'all for asking that question. It's really important to society.
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
For real.
Yeah, reason to society. Reasons, you dig
that was dope,
saying?
Bro.
So how do you deal with your depression? Like, what do you do to deal with your depression?
Oh, man. Shit.
Yeah, that's deep. Because people need to know.
Yes, they do.
They're wondering,
I mean,
trying to figure it out.
You got fans over here that's going through the exact same thing you're going through right now.
You really did, though. What would you say, other than having somebody that was there for you to kind of, like, build you back up?
Yeah, see, when she built me.
But what'd you do for yourself?
Yeah, I'm about to tell you, like, it wasn't ever me.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not even saying on just my wife, because what actually happened one day, this is a true story, like, and it actually what I believe. See, it was all about that, what I believe.
Right.
It was never about what somebody could tell me.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I was... Depression ain't shit nobody can tell you besides make you feel good. Nobody can ever tell you a fact.
Yeah.
Now, although this is my wife now,
during
that time, that was my girl. You feel me? Ain't like we serious. We ain't in love. We big talking. Actually, we friends for real.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went back to my mother probably after that year and a half. Mm-hmm. And she was having some problems around the house or whatever. I'm like, all right, I'm going to come. You feel me? I'm going to just come there. And I need a good shower. And I need some drawers and some tape. You feel me, my dude? I need to feel homey. And she still had my room, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, it was never touched. It still smelled like football again. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, once I went there, I got to clean up, you know, feeling a little worried. And I just start going through it at her house. This is what did it. The truth. It's a mind trick. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Nobody helped me. It's the mind trick. And my mother, she ain't shit for that. But she did that.
Okay, shout out to
I'm about to tell you. I'm about to tell you. She ain't shit for this. But it was the smartest thing she could have did to trick my mind. Mm-hmm. My mother loved gardening. So I knew she was out front gardening this day. Mm-hmm. I knew she was right there around on Riggs Avenue. Mm-hmm. You feel me? By the McDonald's on Franklin.
I already know.
Boom. So she pretended that she hurt her back real bad, like she fell or something with the bag of dirt. Mm-hmm. You feel me? I ran out that bit so fast, like, Mom, you good? What the fuck? Da, 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 da. She's like, nigga, I told you, right? Like, I was like, oh, my God, you ain't shit.
Got
you
him.
Feel me? Got him. And got I was like, she's like, get them gloves. Mm-hmm. I started gardening. Mm-hmm. I started gardening every day. That's the true story, bro. Yeah. And it went from that to finding love of gardening. And then me and my wife just had a whole garden, cucumbers, watermelon, all that. Like, it's just... You would think it would be music, mm-hmm. but music is Garden. Where I let it go.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
What actually took me mentally to get right here was gardening.
My that's man, awesome. Yeah.
Real shit. That's real nigga cool. shit. Real yeah, nigga shit, man. Bro.
I so like that shit. To the people, what, just, I guess, keep your eyes open and just, what? Because, I mean, everybody can't find gardening, or gardening is not going to be the answer for everyone.
Let me tell you.
I guess there's no cookie-cutter answer. It's just about, I guess, finding some type of support, reaching out to somebody, talking about your problems.
I don't think therapy do shit.
You don't think so?
I'm against it.
You know what? Okay, let me ask you this. Do you think depression is a mental thing?
It's all mental.
Right, okay. So do you think that in some cases people choose to dwell in that moment if they fail?
No.
You don't think so?
Mm-mm.
You think they just are just there as a depressed person, you're just there?
Mm-mm. I think what the fuck going on is what's really happening. And I
think, like,
and
about some people who lose people who are depressed because people died. So it's like, I'm reflecting on that memory of this loved one, and now I'm dwelling in this moment for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, because I'm sad and I want them back.
Because it's like, levels to depression. It's levels to depression.
Yeah, depression is real, but it's also a mental thing.
That's why it's all mental right there. Like,
yeah.
You pretty much answered your own question. Like, with the type of people you just mentioned, I can't sound like an asshole right now. You feel me? Because I beat it. But I still go in it. Like, I go way deep. Like, I even call bro sometimes. Like, yo, I got to get out of this. I go deep, bro. You already know. He like, bro, no. We ain't doing it. I'm on my way. I'm about to bring a drink. That's support. You know what I need, nigga? Can play some music or something now. Because I can go there. But no, that's a great question. Like, how can I explain? Like, the biggest problem with depression is one word. Stubborn. The second problem with depression is one word for some. Mm-hmm. Attention.
Mm-hmm. Word. Mm-hmm.
Tell me you ain't see, nigga.
Yeah, you right.
Nigga, that's you ain't even know your uncle, boy.
Mm-hmm. And you just
Why are you acting like you lost your mans?
Well, yeah. I know, yeah.
You just want sympathy.
We got that kind. Then we got the last kind. Am I being too real? Like, you
know,
I saw him talking about you. Bro. I know you felt that one, bro.
Bro, man.
Like, and then you got the one that's like, who was raised a certain way that feel all of that and really don't have a lot of people, mm-hmm. and then lose somebody.
Mm-hmm. Damn.
And their depression is literally losing a family member that's not a family member. And it hurt them so bad, the mental ain't got nothing to do with it no more. It's now your heart is broken, nigga.
I got you, yeah.
Because depression, yo, is... I like that word for it because it's really like... Is to beat depression, you need, first of all, is no stubbornness. You need understanding.
Mm-hmm.
And you need faith.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think
if you don't have those three things for depression, I'm very sorry to tell you, you're most likely to fail until your mind is actually trained to understand that this person's in a better place, this person fought. If the death was unfortunate, such as shot, killed, stabbed, da 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 da. Unwanted cancer, COVID, then you got to allow your body to go through
the stages
and you give your body your mind control that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Your body.
Yeah.
All right, so you give your body a week. Mm-hmm. You give your body 2 weeks to vent that out.
Right.
After that, you start accepting that shit. You cry your ass off at that funeral, and you talk about what they want to see you do. Because if they love you like that, they know you know how they want to see you.
My man,
and that's how you live for after that. I lost a lot of niggas, and there's so many. I'm just the stories never made sense to me.
Yeah,
and I just be like, if I don't make it, he would have whooped my ass. If
my
I don't,
man,
like,
yeah. I'm here,
and I moved.
Let's make something.
I moved.
Yeah,
it was time to get up.
All right,
bro, I cried over you. I'm sorry, because you would have whooped my ass for that if you was in here.
That's a big fact, though, That's a big fact.
You got to know who dying to cry.
Man. Yeah, straight up. Yeah, we definitely appreciate your transparency, most definitely. You know what I'm saying? Mm. That thing got a little bit too
really
deep. You dig
y'all
asked
me, man. Y'all talking mental. I'm going to let it out. I'm a mental person.
Yes, sir, most definitely. You know what I'm saying? You got any special shout-outs for us today, man?
I do, man. I want to shout-out everybody in a city that's really doing something for us, like creativity.
Shout out.
Creativity. And the reason why I didn't pinpoint to nobody, because it's all about that. And before I love business first, I love music.
My man.
Now that I'm a businessman and I'm starting to understand where we're going with this thing.
It's a whole nother realm,
man. It's a lot of bullshit and fuckery that come with business. I just appreciate the artists that never forgot the basics, which was just make good music and hope somebody hear it.
That's what
artists.
You told us last time, man.
Yo, I love them artists, yo. I be listening to artists. I got two artists I'm looking at for the rebuilding of Timeless Music, and these kids is like awesome, but they don't even see it, so I'm trying to bring it out of them before we go. I got to make sure your mental's so strong for this, because we got to make certain type of music, and we not only certain type of music, all types of music. Y'all got to be prepared
every
to switch
genre.
Up.
We're going to take over every single genre.
Shout out to y'all. I'll let y'all name go when it's time. I want to shout out Data Imagine, man.
Oh, yeah.
I want to shout out Data Imagine. That's my bro, right-hand man. You feel me?
Word.
You know, not only is about the camera work that he do and the photogenic work he do, he there for me personally as a friend.
Let's go.
Appreciate you, bro.
I want to
shout out These Beats. These Beats, man. I saw his episode on here. It was the funniest thing ever.
Yeah, he was cool as shit.
Yo,
we're going to have you back on.
Right, we do need
you feel
back
me?
On.
Yo, that shit was hilarious for me, bro.
Yo.
Y'all understand why I was so funny. I was like, I know what all y'all was thinking when he said something. Shit. Like, this nigga is wild, bro.
Yeah.
Shout out Big Steppers.
Shout out
Big Steppers. Shout out y'all, man. Troy Boy, Twan. Shout out Power. You know.
Word up. Shout out.
Shout out City of God.
Shout out.
Shout out Reasons to Society.
Reasons.
I don't think y'all understand how much this means to a culture of our own. And such as this talk today, this is exactly what I told you, bro. I want to go deep in this one.
Yes, sir.
We could talk for another hour if you want. Whatever the fuck y'all want to ask me, because I appreciate this platform. And I feel like this platform need more. Us as a black community, white, Hispanic, we need to pay attention to stuff like this, especially on importance like this.
Yes, sir.
And just give some knowledge to it and shed some light, and it deserves to be that.
Definitely appreciate
y'all
the
giving
flowers,
an opportunity,
brother.
Man. Y'all flowers definitely just came from me, roses.
Most definitely.
Roses.
Definitely appreciate that.
Because niggas interview, but they don't interview.
Yeah, it's not natural and authentic, right?
No.
That's why y'all gotta come to Reasons to Society.
You gotta
don't
come
worry
to
about
Reasons.
It. Don't worry about it, because everybody who don't know, man, I'm about to just flood their DMs. We're gonna make that happen. I feel like there's a lot of people that should be on here.
Yeah,
there's some people's stories that I know personally,
happen, baby.
And I want to know them, and they need to go somewhere where somebody can ask
come
them
on,
the right shit.
The right and they so relatable, bro. Like,
oh my
God, this is what we want from this podcast. We want somebody to be going through the same thing that you're going through and relate to it. You dig what I'm saying? And get the gems. You just dropped a lot of gems for these people out here.
Real shit. That was real shit.
Yeah,
that was amazing, guys.
Come on, man.
I appreciated that. This allowed me to speak. That was crazy.
Yeah, listen, we love picking people's brain and getting their opinions.
That's
and
what it's
how
all
they
about.
Feel.
Hopefully, when y'all listen to the music, y'all can hear it.
Yes, sir.
Very versatile there, too.
The shit, so I got them depression songs, too. That'll wake y'all ass up.
Bring them out.
That's you heard that along before?
No, I'm not too sure, yo. We're going to check that out most definitely as soon as we get wrap this up.
Lower. Let's go.
Y'all know we're about to get into my favorite segment, which is Pick Your Poison.
Let me tell you something before we go here, goddammit.
What? Let us know. What?
Poison, baby.
This fucking segment almost got my head slapped off.
Uh-oh.
What?
the last go round.
Watch what you say, bro.
It was what I said. I was being real. She know I'm not fake, man. Hey. But come on, let's
I don't even
do it.
Remember my part. I'm gonna have to go back and look.
It was right, something that I said to a question that was about you asked that shit.
Oh man, I said, oh, about man. I apologize.
He did it.
So it was his father, it wasn't me.
We don't need no problemos.
Damn.
Would y'all rather take the wrong child home after birth and not find out until they're 12 years old? Yeah, I said it, 12. Or have a child that feels like they're born in the wrong body. So they could be your child, but they born in the wrong body. Girl, she want to be a boy. Boy want to be a girl.
Born in the wrong body.
Or do you want to have that 12-year-old that ain't really yours?
Born in the wrong body.
You got to have a kid that's born in the wrong body?
Yeah, born in the wrong body. Yeah, I'm on the same wave.
And
like,
why y'all?
I mean, that'll destroy you. At least that's me. Like,
right,
like
it's I got to
take full responsibility for that. And plus, that's a feeling. That's not something. Even whether they choose it or it's just a feeling. Like you know
kid,
how
though.
We feel. They're individuals. Right. Yeah, they're my kids, but they're their own individuals. So I'm not gonna shun them or look down on them or disown them because of their sexual preference or how they view themselves. You dig?
Yeah.
Of course, it's hard to deal with. Ain't gonna sit up in here like it's gonna be all good.
Right.
It's gonna be hard to deal with, but I'd rather deal with that than, you know.
I'm a strong supporter. I'm already a strong supporter of my kid, and I can't imagine this being my kid for 12 years.
And it's not yours.
And it's not mine. And I'm a father and I'm a stepfather. Mm-hmm. And I'm a father to all of them.
Yeah. Right,
so just imagining me holding something that's not mine off the break.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
For 12
I can't.
Years.
I'd rather mine be mine and support you the same way I support mine now. Yeah. I don't want you to be somebody that don't belong here. Because let me tell you something. If you don't belong here, I'm going to treat your ass like spaghetti strings.
All right, so I'm going to go with the same answer simply because at the end of the day, it's your child. Like, I would not want to lose a kid. Because you're losing a kid. It was never yours, so you got to take it back.
Right.
Well, if it's 12 years old, like, how do you take it back?
Exactly. You got a certain attachment at that point. Like,
I know.
Just because you found out don't mean your real child, no.
Yeah, but what if your real child, you know, now you're getting a swap back? Would you want your kid back?
A swap back?
Would you want your kid
back? He probably don't even like your real kid at that point.
Would you want your real kid?
He probably don't even like him. He probably was in a household where it's though, like, you got to reshape this whole.
Yeah, that's a fucked up question.
Think about it at 12. He probably wouldn't like you either. Like, all right, if he ain't had no discipline and then you put him in his household, you like,
hey, bro. Like, that's a fucked up question. Hey, look.
You been at?
Hey, look. Hey, come on. Let me meet you real quick. What's your name?
Would you want your kid back, though?
Malvin.
Yeah, like, what?
Your name is Malvin.
Right, yo. You got to learn.
Malvin what?
Exactly, yo.
Craney.
Come on,
yo. Okay, Malvin Craney. Okay, since we just found out we swap babies, give me this baby. Okay. That baby come in my house.
Right,
no, he's a teenager now. That teenager come in my house.
Preteen.
I'm going to tell you something.
I ain't trying to hear none of that.
You don't understand what's going on here? Now, gender of who that child was raised at, it already explains because his name is Malvin Craney.
Mm-hmm. Wear it up.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I don't know how that would get mixed up a baby.
But already.
You know what I'm saying? If you don't get this fucking household, give me give me Junior back, Dummy.
Hey,
Dummy, give me Junior back. Hey, Malvin.
I don't want to have to go through no child abuse, no CPS, no none of that.
You better get that shit.
You 12. You feel me? We don't need them issues at 12. He hitting on me. You damn right, yo.
You damn right he hitting on you, Malvin. You better get your ass up and hit him back. I'm sorry. I got girls, yo, and I got one son. And I was scared.
Mm-hmm.
For real. Bobbies and shit.
I know
everywhere.
That nigga
said, get that shit out of here, man.
I mean, his daddy got too much testosterone leaking up off on
me. Fuck that nigga. I don't care how much I got. That man was surrounded by women all his life and they love him dearly.
Yeah,
and let me tell you, this boy is tough for 6 years old. And I still say,
you met him, right?
Yeah, most of but he a bully. You know what I'm saying? That's a whole nother story.
He straight
bullied me out of the house.
By the way, guys, follow his IG page.
Most
it's his
definitely.
Football page. His Rambuster Pines. All his highlights. King_strong, though.
You dig?
Nigga's crazy.
All right, so, y'all, we are all picking that we would rather have the child with the identity crisis than
Malvin and them.
Malvin Craney.
Malvin Craney.
All
that. All right,
we're going to get into the next segment, which is GTT time, and that's Girl Talk with... So, have y'all ever heard of babies? Since we on the topic,
rabies.
I thought you said babies.
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 Yeah, babies.
In a trap. I don't get it. What's
All right, so babies are basically babies that get to pick their own gender. So there's parents that are in the United States that feel like when they have a baby, they want that child to decide what they want to be. So
what? What are you talking about?
Where is this at? Heard me.
Where is this at?
What country is this?
The baby
this
can't. The a baby or a child? The baby can't talk.
So they have the baby. Okay. And then as the toddlers, they call it. So on the birth certificate, it doesn't have boy or girl. It has baby. Okay? So as this little baby grows up.
I feel how I'm looking at it.
That's how I felt when I heard it. I was like, what? So they got their baby because they don't want their baby to decide what they want to be. So if it's a boy, they don't want to sit here and put pink toys or put it in boy clothes.
Baby,
you know when the baby come out, it's a gender, right?
You feel what I'm saying? But the parent doesn't want the baby to know that. So this is my thing, y'all. This is legal. They could do, yeah.
Who is they?
Right, who is they?
Well, you know, they're clearly not our color, the people who are doing this. But like they, in these states, they're all around.
The United States.
That's a fair disadvantage in life. That's not fair,
bro. So this is my thing. So what do y'all think? Like, so they feel like this is beneficial for the kid, right? Because they feel like it allows them to choose what gender they want to be. But my thing is,
I never chose.
Yeah.
Did you ever choose?
That's why I wanted to talk about it. Ain't the shit wild? Like, how did your baby get to choose what your baby want to be?
They're giving a baby a responsibility, a lifetime responsibility. At what?
Let's say four, five, six
is at least the first grade you're starting to comprehend.
Okay, let's say kindergarten.
Six.
But they say at that age they don't know the difference between boys and girls. At 5, 6.
It's a damn lie.
I thought.
My son got in the shower and was looking at his mother.
Yeah, because you know it's different, right?
He's flicking his shit, scratching his balls.
You want kids to be naive.
And that's what I'm saying. It's almost like these kids are fucking stupid.
Yeah.
He's listening to everything that you say, and he's watching everything that you do, but you think he's so naive. But then,
especially if they drinking breast milk.
All that.
They actually enhance if you're drinking breast milk opposed to Similac.
I definitely agree with that.
That's the truth. That's facts.
That's the natural search.
Yeah, if you get the natural milk from the mom, the kid is way more.
How do you feel about breastfeeding until the breast milk is no longer? Like, because they try to put a certain age limit on it. Like, you should stop at 3, 4,
there's no age limit on breastfeeding. You should,
like, as long as you develop the milk.
The moment your child say, dada.
Oh, all right.
No more titty.
As the father, son, you're not going to keep sucking on my titty. That's my titty.
But what about this, though? Like, let me take it a step up. What if you pump the breast milk and then give it to them in like a
That's
cup,
acceptable.
Cup? Yeah.
I don't feel like, I'm not going to say it's not acceptable for a woman who does this. Mm-hmm. Because I never seen a woman with a 3-year-old feeding her child like that.
Yeah.
To be honest.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you got a baby and you in public and all that shit, you got to feed your fucking kid. Yeah, like, I'm with all that. Your kid 3 years old, walking and shit, talking and shit, talking about
go sit down. Or coming and taking your titty out for the
milk.
Yeah,
you're not about to do that.
It sounds weird, but breast milk gotta be in there for a reason.
It's there for 5 years, so it makes you wonder how long should people be breastfeeding.
For at least 5 years.
I don't mind pumping the milk out and giving it to you, but I don't.
If you breastfeeding around that age, you should be pumping it.
We got so off topic.
I agree. It leads into babies. Like, so basically, let me ask y'all this. Do y'all think we should have gender roles?
No.
We shouldn't have gender roles?
I'm just saying, gender roles.
What do you mean?
As far as like males are supposed to do this specific thing, females should be doing this, like cooking, cleaning.
When we get a 24 case of water from Walmart, who do you think carries it up and down the steps?
All over the place.
It depends on how far we're going to it.
Because if you think about it, if these parents don't believe in gender roles, that's why they're having babies.
Oh, okay.
You got me? So they don't want their kid to grow up thinking, oh, a man is supposed to do this, a woman is supposed to do this. So that's why I'm asking y'all, do y'all think
why the baby crawling, you just letting she-man do what the fuck she want until you decide what you think the baby want to be?
So it's no toys, or it's like boy that. Toys over here, girl baby. Toys over there, so then you just see which way that they go. Like, oh, he
they probably
the
supposed
to, that's like the new TikTok. Is it coming with daddy and mommy?
Exactly.
Like,
no,
like,
yeah. We ain't doing
so
that.
So with these particular kids that I saw, they were twins. I think they were twin boys, but they had on rainbow tights. Like leggings?
Who put it on them?
A fair disadvantage.
Exactly.
So it's like, how did they find that they wanted to wear this?
Word up. Fair disadvantage.
So it's just weird to me. And it's like, it's even to the point where, before I wanted to talk about this, I wanted a little bit more information, but since we own a damn topic, I might as well. So there's like this 13-year-old little girl that wants to be a boy. And in this specific state, I'll look that up so I can tell y'all later. But in the specific state, they're allowed to get a sex change at 13, and the parent cannot do anything about it. And the parent also has to address that child as the sex that they choose to be.
Cool.
And if you go against it, it could be, I don't know if it's a legal thing where you'll get locked up, but like it's a serious thing. You heard about that?
It's actually, when a child makes the decision, you can't go by that.
You can't go against it, and you have to address them as such. It's kind of crazy. Like, it's just getting to the point where it's like,
that's the word child. A child cannot make those type of decisions.
At 13, hell no.
You can't even smoke a cigarette.
No, I mean, as a child, 12 o'clock is off the clock. 12 o'clock, you're off the clock. You're now a teenager, young man, young woman. And I'm not going to say, if my son or my daughter come to me and they're 13 years old and say, Dad, I want to be the opposite of what I am today. This is how I feel. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. I'm not fucking paying for it.
Mm-hmm. So that's what I said.
If it's something you really want, then go for it, dog. Yeah, but I'm not going to pay for that.
Get you a summer job. Mm-hmm. Go get you a little tight.
You're going to need more than summer.
All that. I'm just saying. I'm not spending my money on your hobbies or whatever you got going on.
I'm a strong supporter of my kids, so.
Big facts.
Whatever route they want to go, I'm with you. Yeah. You feel me? It's just how you going to handle it and how much from me as far as energy you need.
Mm-hmm.
Straight up. I was raised like that. Like, if I want to do something and I feel like my mother couldn't handle it, I'm that baby. I got 20 to it, but you might need to work on the other 75 if you really want to do it that bad.
Like
if you go, you meet me a quarter way, not even halfway sometimes, depending on how drastic. Now, that's drastic.
Word up.
Sex change is drastic. Yes, that's all you.
Yeah, that's a life altering decision.
That's all you,
bro.
Yeah. You got to really know.
Not at that age.
Yeah, but I just figured let's talk about that real quick. But
that was crazy. Babies.
Yeah. Babies, guys.
Babies.
Babies.
Let's go ahead and get into the last segment, which is asking for a friend.
Oh, shit.
Guys, are y'all
That's
listening?
That's where the fuck she got in trouble, too.
Uh-oh.
I need that advice.
More trouble.
All right, so I have a friend that has a 9-year-old son, right?
Mm-hmm.
The son's father is not in the son's life, right? So for 9 years, he's been like in and out, flowing in and out.
So he's the stepfather.
Yeah, basically. Okay. He's the stepfather. So my friend has not put this man on child support for the whole 9 years. She's been, you know, trying to work with him, you know, not be that crazy baby mother. Like, you know, most women would, I'm going to put your child support. Or they want to be crazy because they're not together no more. Or, you know, she accepts it. They're not together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she's moved on with her life. She's now married.
Okay.
And the husband... It's probably been in a child's life for, I'll say, like 4 years, maybe.
Right.
And he is telling his wife, give him one more chance. Don't put him on child support. Give him another chance. And she's like, no. Like, at this point, I'm ready to put him on child support.
Right.
So her question is, should she go behind her husband's back and just do it?
What?
Or should she consider it again? Because, you know, people like to consider with their spouse.
Yeah.
You know,
I ain't going to stunt. The considering is cool, but, like, you literally have nothing to do with this situation.
Yeah, I
like,
agree.
You know what I mean?
I agree.
Like,
I think if he had more years on the life, he did.
That's number one. And number two, what is wrong with homie? You talking about give him one more chance? What are you talking about, dog?
Like, and my thing is, the dad only comes around during tax time.
That's not
so it's
your
like,
kid.
How much do you really care about your son?
How you even got to say so in this whole situation as just the husband? Like, that's not your kid. You dig what I'm saying?
But naturally,
she had a previous.
But naturally, I'm going to angle
give
lie.
Him one more chance.
Yeah, I would
to take care of his child that's been running around here
for
9 years.
But you never know. You never know, bro. And I'm a stepdad, too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm a father, so mm-hmm. I'm a father to all.
Word.
But I'm a stepdad and not a stepdad.
Straight
you know,
right.
y'all get
yeah,
what I'm saying.
You're the daddy.
But I done seen situations in this predicament. And, you know, I told my wife in times of hardship with them, like, I stood up for him before.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it's out of respect for the children. He's not saying that shit for him.
Exactly. And that's
he's saying
how
that shit
too,
for
the
strength
child,
of you
the
really
child.
Not gonna see this nigga now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You feel me?
Right.
You really not. The whole time the nigga ain't gonna pay child support if he ain't working anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So if he only come around tax time, let's do the math, the nigga ain't doing shit.
Word. Mm-hmm.
And if he is doing shit, he got a whole nother family. You feel me?
Yeah.
That's how I look at it, but if I feel like if the woman and she was, it was 4 years in, and I'm your husband within 4 years, see, I was with my wife for a long time before we got married, but I don't think that's well enough to say you raised this child yet.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel like you raised that child yet.
Yeah, yeah.
4 years, you ain't raised it.
Yeah.
Mm. It's very possible you're not dad yet to that child. Word up. But 9 times out of 10, you ain't saying the regular father.
You dig what I'm saying? Yeah. He's a big influence on in your life.
Right, yeah. So, because he's taking care of him financially with the wife. So, you know, I mean, at this point, he is like the father figure. But I definitely think you need to put that nigga on
child support. But I don't know what's to it. But that nigga, he must be having a good motive to doing that.
Mm-hmm.
Because he must guide it to his, like, you don't need that nigga money.
Exactly.
Right, but
people don't forget, like, nigga, it's not even about the money.
Right, it's the principle. Like, the good woman
don't care about the money.
That's why it's just weird for him to say, don't worry about it. It's like, okay, like, I work, that. You work, you dig what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But some man created a kid that he's not taking care of, so it's just like, yo.
Yeah.
9 years.
9 years. 9 years. That's
and I've been
like,
around for four.
Hold
so
on. How long
before
was,
me, it
was
5 years.
How long was he around when the baby came, though?
Say it was in and out, right?
It was like in and out. Like,
never.
I'm talking about their relationship. Was they together?
Yeah, they were together. And he was probably in the child's life for the first, I'll say, like, first 6 months.
Oh, no. I put that nigga on.
Yeah.
And then come around maybe
just like you
birthday,
said, he probably got a whole
other
family.
Yeah.
But he's spending that money on his other family.
Put that nigga on.
Yeah.
So we all, friend? Child support.
A child always needs something. Summer camp, something. You dig what I'm saying? When we come up short, he need to pick up his slack.
I just feel like if two people we should be the picking kid, up two his people slack. Need to be taking care of that child.
You
know,
yeah.
Straight up.
Yeah, I'm with the support on that. 6 months, he only been, oh yeah, no.
Yeah, you ain't put it, yeah. Child support.
Once you met the love of your life, you should have did that.
Exactly. Yeah,
it's crazy, because I got a friend right in this car.
Oh, but the question was go behind his back. No.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
So what I mean? So just tell him she gonna do it.
Yeah,
tell him you gonna do it.
If he say no,
I'm gonna put him on there. Yeah, you don't like it or not. You gave me a suggestion.
Right. Straight up.
I'm not gonna do that though. I'm going down there.
Yeah. So
that's
don't
how
do it behind his back, but you're gonna do it regardless.
Yeah, don't go behind his back. Don't ever
do
that. You married now, baby.
Yeah, straight up. You know what I'm saying? My friend got a similar story, though. It's kind of similar. You dig what I'm saying? I got a homeboy. He started talking to a young lady. You dig what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
She just got out of a relationship not too long ago. You dig what I'm saying? She's having problems with her ex. Won't leave her alone, calling, texting. Mm-hmm. And my homeboy want to know, like, how soon is too soon
before he go off
to approach homie about the situation. You dig what I'm saying?
What is he approaching him about?
Calling her up?
Yeah, calling her, texting her.
I feel like she should be putting that in check, though.
Of
like,
course. Stop calling me. Stop texting me. Boom, boom.
Block
like,
him.
Okay, so then what do you do? Call the police at this point?
No.
Is it the police or your boyfriend at this point?
You do the logical,
or keep it. Let
you do the logical shit. This nigga ain't. If he popping up,
yeah,
that's different. Like you want to call niggas is just hungry and thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
It's something you can't stop. Especially it's like playing the game with somebody and he talking shit on
you. Mm-hmm. Word. He in a whole nother state. You talking about let's meet up.
I'm not fuck you. Shut up, bro. Like, are you fussing with that man? You ain't never gonna see him. But now, if he live in the same city,
mm-hmm.
he pop up on your girl, he gotta get beat.
Word up.
Straight up. But if he keep calling the phone, you answer it, nigga.
Right, and then.
But I'm saying, though, how soon is too soon? You dig what I'm saying? We talking about
never
2 weeks?
Too late.
You dig what I'm saying?
Never too late.
I would say.
Because I feel like, yo, some people don't even know the person they're dealing with. You dig what I'm saying? Like, she could have a pattern of doing this. You dig what I'm saying?
Right.
She probably been with the same dude for 20 years, right?
Doing the
so
same
then
shit.
She'll mess with Henry on the side. He'll come beat him up, do whatever.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? And all these entanglements all the time. You just came along. You found this great woman, you dig what I'm saying, but you don't know her past at all. Now she about to put you in a blender just like everybody else.
Everybody,
I don't know. I tell her straight up, like, well, who the nigga is? If you lie to me one bit, I'm
gonna
walk.
You
don't like that,
but I guess you gotta call him and find out, right? He should be telling you what's up.
Hell no.
No.
Never listen to another nigga.
Exactly. Right, I don't even understand how does that happen. Like, what's his number?
No, when he called, be like, what's up?
Why you calling my girl? You dig what I'm saying? What's up is basically like, yo, next time I see you, you dig what I'm saying? I don't like third-party beef. That's how, like, okay, I think it's sweet, but you on it. You dig what I'm saying? So next time I see you, I think it's sweet. Mm-hmm. You straight on my head.
Exactly.
So, no. Hey,
you get to handle that properly.
Right.
Now, the phone conversation should say, put her on the phone. Now, what you going to say after that?
Mm-hmm.
You talking to me. Okay, now it's beef.
Right.
One of y'all feeling a certain way. You dig what I'm saying? That's not going to. So what's
damn,
too soon?
A,
what's too soon?
I don't know.
Is it a time period? Do y'all have to have a kid together? Y'all got to get married, move in together, have a bill together?
No.
Like what? Like how?
I'm going to say you get a week.
A week? Damn. Talking to a female for a week and you beating niggas up over
Georgia? Wait. Oh, I thought you meant like before I step in his face. He want to handle
a situation. Before you step, a week? So I'm saying like you meet a chick within a week. She tell you like, boom.
The moment you declare you mine.
You dig? That's what I'm saying. Now we talking.
When it's established that we're together.
When you declare we together. It's official. When it's official.
Yeah, I don't even think together. I think love. Like. Yeah, a lot of people be together because, you know, beginning stage, we really like each other.
But you gotta know that y'all really trying to be. But love takes time. You fall in love after 3 months. Exactly. Within 3 months, you gonna let somebody just keep talking to your girl?
And think about my answer.
Kind of seen the fall in love.
How you gonna fall in love with a nigga in the middle in your fucking face?
And you still wanna play.
You know what I'm saying? That's why I said as soon as you determine your mind, because if I can't fall in love with you, you got this nigga keep calling, and you ain't handling it, I'm gonna fall in love with you. So it gotta be the moment. Will you determine you
mine? That's what I'm talking about. Now I physically want to do something, yo, because you mine. You mine. Like, hey, you're not my property, but you know what I'm talking about. Like, yo, I protect you now. Right. You dig what I'm saying?
That's it.
But I ain't about to be the boyfriend that is might work, it might not work.
Yeah.
But I'm out here, like, approaching other dudes about, yo, you texting my girl? Yo, it's my girl. Yeah. Because you don't know what she's telling yo.
You definitely right about that.
Yeah, I'm with him now.
If a nigga keep calling a girl and we together for 12 months, and he cannot stop calling her.
It wouldn't have made it 12 months.
Bitch, you find the time to call him.
It wouldn't have made it 12 months, yo.
It wouldn't have made it 12 months.
Yeah, I'm going to say, that's why I was like.
You know I can't.
You know,
you're giving them some
are y'all really going to talk to somebody? Y'all been talking to somebody for, but see, that's the thing. Like, so you talk to somebody for 3 months, and the whole 3 months, the same person keeps calling them.
Yeah. There's something going on.
Before that, you have to get out of there because you're going to fall in love with this person who is attached to somebody else's bag.
And then something's going to come about.
And even though they don't want that bag, it's just what they come with.
Yeah.
Exactly.
If you bring in some drama like this, no, bro. You got a nigga that's going to kill me over you, and I don't even know why.
Yeah, like Fatal Attraction.
He might have a key. He might have a key. You don't even know. You kicked him out, but
you don't change the number. I'd be damned if you change the key to this lock.
Did y'all see that man on Facebook that kicked down his ex-wife's door? Like, he busted her house. And she had to shoot him.
Some people, yo, are you ready to die about that? That's why I said I'm waiting for love. I'm waiting for, like, yo, you about to meet my mother. We going on trips together. Instagram lit like us.
Yeah,
love, like,
but you're still in love with a person who's has baggage that you could still die.
Of course,
now you're in love with a person that's still gonna get you.
But to even get there, you know what you're dealing with. Love, right. You dig what I'm saying? Like is different. Like, I like her, but I ain't coming around on the weekends because homie crazy, he liable to pop up. Love is yo. I'm here, yo. Like, he keep popping up. Something gotta be done about this. You dig? Mm-hmm. Now you're the protector. You're not the. Oh, I'm out. Like. You feel what I'm saying? Right. Like, no, we got to be in love.
Right.
I got to love you.
So our answer for your friend is inclusion.
I just said love.
Wait for love.
Wait for love, bro. Wait till you know that you're going to at least pursue the relationship 100%.
Right, it's going to be
Don't
serious.
Be fighting over no chick that's for this thing.
Yeah, scope it out, man.
Yeah, scope.
Scope it out. Scope out the scene.
He being sneaky, but sometimes you got to.
12 months still calling. No, we ain't doing that.
No, it's been a really great episode, though. Thank you again for coming out and seeing definitely. Us again for the second time. Yeah, let the people know where they can find you again.
Remy Ruger. All platforms.
Google.
Google him.
Insta.
You can use your sound
Spotify,
PlayStation.
YouTube.
Pretty much on all platforms. I got a lot of new stuff coming out. June 3rd, my single Done With Lies will be available for pre-order.
Okay.
It's only $1.29. I hope everybody go out there and
support,
purchase that.
Support.
The 5th, it'll be out on all streaming platforms. Out of My Mind Acoustic is out right now.
Fire.
Shot by Data Imagine. shout out to G Lee for making that one happen for sure. Shout out to my brother Truck for letting that happen. What else I got? And I really think because the Split Decisions is on hold, I very well made drop Uncomplacent.
Okay.
And that's probably like my most anticipated y'all gonna enjoy.
Word it up, my man. Looking forward to that most.
That's supposed to be the zone.
Guys, you make sure you follow us on IG at Reasons to Society. If you have any friends
ASAP
that need any advice, you email us at reasonstosociety@gmail.com. We'll help them anonymously.
Yeah, dig.
Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notification. Until next time.
We out, baby.
Bye.
Yeah.